tonight. It's gotta be baby tonight. You gotta see your baby or else baby you don't see your baby at all. You gotta kiss baby tonight. I must insist, baby, I'm right. You gotta kiss baby or miss baby and miss your baby you've gone. If you hesitate, you're gone. That's what the proverb said to you. You know, baby, love goes on. So why don't you use your big head? You gotta see baby tonight. Don't you see, baby, I'm right. You gotta see baby or else baby you don't see baby at all.
Adrian Heskin there on Drover's Lane, enjoying a fine season, almighty season, as we head back for the 2:35. It's a handicap chase over 3 miles without number 6 Cougars Gold. It leaves a field of 7. Let's have a look at the betting as the jockeys make their way into the parade ring. Rylex, the one-eared Rylex, is your 7-4 favourite. Mm-hmm. Love the Leader is a 2-1 second in. Hard Station 6-1. Ballycamp is 13-2. It's 20-1, a bigger price as the rest, as we get back to Gordon Martin on track.
Cheers for that. Now, this Rylax heads the market on 74, an absolute romp at Carlisle, Martin. Got the penalty and due to go up a bit more as well.
Yeah, plenty more. So he's officially £8 well in under the penalty today, and he did win very easily, didn't he? He looked a transformed character, really. The hood was off, pinged his way around fence to fence, travelled like a dream, and had the race won a fair way out. So, you know, if he's in that form again, you can see him there. I think that's him.
Yep, minus the ear.
Minus the left ear, yeah. And I say I think that's him, obviously, I knew it was.
Yeah.
If he's in the same form again, you've got to respect him. It is a much longer trip today, particularly with the added distance that we've got, and I think he will get harried a little bit at the head of a third. Hard Station is a horse that invariably goes forward. He's quite a hard puller, so him and Rylex could end up dueling a little bit. It should make the race a proper test of stamina, and whether that is exactly what he wants, I don't know. You know, it's a significant step up in tripping what's probably going to be a strongly run race, but like I say, he's well in under the penalty.
He looks in really good condition. Well, conflicting sort of reports as to how he lost his ear. I mean, speaking to Skew and Lucinda, it could have been a dog bite. It could have been trapped in a gate or something, so they're not really sure. They tried him with the hood and they took the hood off at Carlisle and he fairly romped to victory. I think Skew said to me after he won at Carlisle that the way he holds his head in races, he feels there's something different on that side. As you can imagine, he's not like a one-eyed horse, for example, but he just seems to feel
you would do, wouldn't you? And look, at the end of the day, didn't stop him at Carlisle last time out, and you know, maybe just taking that hood off him and letting him feel the fresh air a little bit has helped him or whatever. But no, he looked on a horse on good terms with himself, as is Love the Leader, who looks for
the price has been collapsed a little bit. It's 4-1 from 6-1. Is it stable money, Richard?
It's not, certainly not my money. I haven't got any, unfortunately.
I don't believe that for a minute. Good luck.
Thanks very much indeed.
There you are, as you can see then, Hard Station 6-1 all the way into 4-1. Martin Dixon was listening intently.
Profile like a horse probably that hasn't been the easiest to train necessarily. He's got a bit of a lightly raised profile. He's missed time off here and there throughout his career. But, you know, if he was back to his very best, then...
And they're off, jumping away, all of them away okay. Les Fremantle at the back of the field early on. Hard Station, plenty of money around for him beforehand, and he's gone striding off with the lead already at the first. Hard Station and soared over that, cleared it with feet to spare ahead of Rylex in second place and Love the Leader in third. Hard Station at fence number 2. He can jump kindly, this horse, loads and loads of scope. The back markers include Ballycamp and Sands Cove and Show Him Silver, Les Fremantle at the back end of the field. Over fence number 3, pretty impressive over these first 3 as Hard Station been, and now comes Bias with 2 circuits to go with a clear lead. Harry Bannister on board, really taking the bull by the horns here. Hard Station clear by 15 lengths over Rylex and Love the Leader, and then comes Ballycamp towards the inside, then Sands Cove together with Show Him Silver, and Les Fremantle to the rear end of the field as Hard Station maintaining a clear 12-length advantage over the field, and he heads down to the back straight for the first time. Been fun watching him over the first three fences, and lots more opportunity to see him at his fences now. Four fences in a line coming right up. Here's Hard Station at the next plain fence, over that one in fine style from Ryalex, who's now fully 20 lengths behind in second place. Love the leaders over safely in third. And Hard Station now makes his way down towards the first open ditch with this huge lead. At the ditch, again over in grand style. Ryalex just coming to it now. Ryalex pops over it okay. Les Fremantle in touch at the back with Show 'em Silver. But Hard Station now to a plain fence, and again measured that one beautifully. Hard Station then making quite an impact. Well, this made a mistake at that previous fence. Meanwhile, Hard Station's already at the last over on the far side. And then Ryalex together with Love the Leader. Show 'em Silver up on the wide outside. Sands Cove together with Ballycamp and Les Fremantle to the rear of the field. Ballycamp ridden away from that fence. They don't seem inclined to go chasing Hard Station just yet, this chasing group. Lobbing along in second place. But there's no escaping the fact that Hard Station has a huge lead as they sweep now downhill towards the home straight for the first time. Hard Station then is now, I would say, 35 or 40 lengths clear of the chasers. Ryalex back in second place. Ryalex with Love of Ballycamp, Les Fremantle, and Show 'em Silver. So if this continues, Hard Station will be jumping one fence while the others are jumping a completely different one. Here's Hard Station, just put himself right at the first fence in the home straight. That was number 8. His jumping's been fantastic, and he's well clear from Ryle, a little bit close. Can he keep this up? He's a good 30 to 35 lengths clear. Ryle X, Love the Leader, and the others all safe and sound. A little nudge of that, the 10th fence, and now a circuit to go for Hard Station, still with a huge lead. Ryalex blundered quite badly over that next fence. Quite a jarring mistake there from Ryalex. With him is Love the Leader and Ballycamp, followed then by Sands Cove and Show 'em Silver. Les Fremantle still well in touch relative to the other runners in the race, but not one of them is anywhere near Hard Station yet as they come now on their final circuit in an intriguing FMCG Executive Network handicap chase. Can he keep this up, Hard Station? His lead, not as big as it once was, is down to about 18, 20 lengths perhaps, Hard Station. Ryalex and Love the Leader, together with Ballycamp, they all turn huddled together with Sands Cove and also Show 'em Silver and Les Fremantle, but down the far side, Hard Station, that time close again. From Ryalex in second, Ryalex followed by Love the Leader, and again, Love the Leader, not for the first time, a little bit untidy. Ballycamp is being ridden along once again. Hard Station now approaches the penultimate open ditch. Was asked for a big one, jumped a fantastic leap at that one. From Ryalex and Love the Leader, Sands Cove and Les Fremantle, who has gone past Show 'em Silver and the ridden along Ballycamp. Next one is a plain one, and there Hard Station seemed to get that wrong on the approach to it, but still gallops on by some 18 or 20 lengths from Ryalex in second and Love the Leader in third place. Final ditch, much better again then from Hard Station. That was another good jump, and Ryalex squeezed along perhaps for the first time. The gap is down to 10 or 12 lengths now. Will it reduce further? Love the Leader's in third place. Sands Cove is in fourth. Les Fremantle plugging on. Clear of Show 'em Silver to the rear end of the field. Hard Station then has been clear throughout. He's now leading by about 8 or 9 lengths over Ryalex in second place and Love the Leader in third. He's got a clear lead, or has had a clear lead throughout the race, but now for the first time being pushed along Hard Station to maintain that advantage over Ryalex and Love the Leader. Old Les Fremantle plugging on alongside Sands Cove next as they now motor on down towards the third last fence. Hard Station at 3 out. His jumping remains really good. Ryalex closing, though, all the time. And Hard Station now looking as though he's about to tread water. Ryalex joins him on the far side. Ryalex didn't jump too well there, though. And Hard Station back with the advantage. Ryalex will need to come again. Love the leader and Les Fremantle third and fourth. Another good jump on the last from Hard Station. Is he going to see off Ryalex, or can Ryalex find a bit more on the run-in? Hard Station from Ryalex. The gap is just a length still. Hard Station, as game as you like. Hard Station seeing off Ryalex. Hard Station, brilliant round of jumping, clear by a long way at halfway, clung on grittily to win by just over a length from Ryalex. And after those, love the leader.
As we pick up the closing stages then, with a circuit or so to go, and bring in Martin back in. At this point, Martin, the winner still well clear and just jumping away in front. And as Harry says, he was told beforehand, this horse is your own way of doing things. Let him go on with it.
Yeah, and I think it's the right way, because if you tried to fight him at all, he'd just probably been too keen. He's been that way before, and he's just letting bowl along. And there was a point in the race, I think about a circuit out, where Harry had a look under his legs, and I don't think he could quite, probably couldn't quite believe how far clear he was.
That.
And he's, I mean, he's just a really big, enthusiastic horse with a long stride, and he just really, for much of the race, he galloped them into submission, didn't he? And you thought when he got challenged by Ryalex that the writing was on the wall, he was beaten. He looked out on his feet at the time briefly, but very gamely, as you said, he just kept on sticking at it. And his jumping was one major aspect of the performance as well, wasn't it? You see him there, just really bold at his fences. Obviously a massive attribute that he's got. And when you've got a big, enthusiastic, long-striding horse that jumps well, why not just let him get on with things and, you know, jump from fence to fence? That was probably about his only mistake down the back straight there. He just got in a little bit tight, but he was clever at it. Didn't make a mistake. And like I say, he's serving energy with every jump, really, isn't he, compared to some of his rivals?
And I know there was a Rule 4 involved here, with Cougar's goal being a non-runner today, but some punters were talking 14 or 16 to 1 yesterday, last night, sent off a much shorter price than that, and the gamble continued on course, as we spoke about after we'd spoken to Richard Bandy.
Yeah, most significantly, the sort of close to the race money was all for him, wasn't it? And the two market leaders, who were strong enough in the betting themselves, were putting up a bit of resistance to make quite a strong market, but obviously plenty of money about for him, and he's justified it very, very determinedly. It's this point here where you're turning into the straight, there's still a long way from home, you know how much he's already put in to sort of racing as far clear as what he did for much of the way, and it looked like he was going to be swallowed up, but he just keeps on finding.
He does, and he's game, and well, a good story as well with the trainer having his first winner under rules.
Yeah, absolutely, and I think it made it a fascinating race to watch all the way through as well. You don't very often see a horse go clear in that manner that he did today, and you know, it was just a very different, made for a very different type of race, and all got very interesting at the straight there. But even at the last, he jumps so well, doesn't he? He's so quick over it.
We're just hearing in the aftermath of that as well, Harry's got a 4-day whip band.
Yes, he sort of mentioned that, didn't he, quickly off air, he's picked up a banner. Not a chance to count them up myself, but no doubt the stewards have. And loved the leader there. He was battling away in third, wasn't he? If they'd have gone another furlong or so, he might have pegged back the first two, because they were. Basically treading water in the closing stages, and he was still finding a little bit at one pace.
And Richard Bandy, 16, room for 16, I think he said. He's got license for 16, he's got 9 in training. You would think off the back of this, people will say, well, I might be sending him a horse.
Yeah, he trains in.
If you hesitate, you're gone.
That's what Proverbs said. You know, baby, love goes on. Why don't you use your big fat head? You gotta see me, baby, tonight. Don't you see me, baby, I'm right. You gotta see your baby, or else, baby, you don't see me, baby, at all. No, you don't see your baby, not at all.